When can cryptocurrency cease to exist? For stocks, it can cease to exist due to the firm's bankruptcy or merger. If possible, when and why can a cryptocurrency cease to exist? For example, is it possible for Bitcoin to suddenly become value $0 at some point? I am actually looking for a technical answer. A fiat money becomes worthless when the government that backs the currency becomes very high credit risky and etc. or if no one believes the government can pay the IOUs. This argument applies to a cryptocurrency as well. But I am looking for a technical type answer that involves system failure, mining cost, and the like.
When the network lacks sufficient processing power to protect against attack. Take a look at CoinYi West. There have been no trades since 2017 and the currency is considered defunct. Essentially, Kanye West sued them for using his name and likeness, and the original developers dumped their coins. Interest waned and the network lost 99% of its processing power, and the coins lost essentially all of their value. Remember, cryptocurrencies count on the built-in redundancy of thousands or millions of independent servers, each run by someone who holds that currency and wants it to be as secure as possible. If you don't have a critical mass of investors, then it's pretty easy to orchestrate a 51% attack such as the attack on Ethereum. To drive this point home even further, Crypto51.app has listed prices per hour to perform 50% attacks on most cryptocurrencies. Edit. A commenter mentioned loss of quorum. This is the technical way of saying there are not enough third-party observers to validate any future transactions. All cryptocurrencies work by having two entities announce their transaction in public, the internet. If it were in English, it would sound something like, I, Jack, would like to give Jill coin number 723. The third-party observers all pull out their ledgers and look. Jack owns coin number 723, so this is legit. Over the next little while they confer with each other and all agree Jack really did own coin number 723 and gave it to Jill. They all add this transaction in their ledgers. If only a few of the observers disagree, they are shouted down by the rest of the observers and agree to change their ledgers. That last sentence is the key to understanding attacks. Now for the 51% attack, Jill has a majority of the third-party observers in her pocket. She decides to sell coin number 723 to Bob, Ashley, and a whole bunch of other people. She can get away with this because her gang of third-party thugs is larger than the rest of the group put together, and they will convince everyone she only spent the coin once, when in fact she spent it multiple times. Jill has a short window to double spend. It won't be too long before all the duped people start talking and realize that Jill has the town in her pocket, and simply stop accepting coins as payment. All that's left are the criminal scum who agreed to rig the system to begin with. This leads to a loss of quorum. Essentially, when none of the third-party observers trust each other enough to agree on anything. Even if one or two new people join in, they don't have the critical mass of observations needed to ensure the integrity of the system, and the whole thing falls apart. In this example, loss of quorum is when there are not enough third-party observers to shout down the holdouts with a unified narrative of what happened.